everybody said they wanted a young urban audience, and everybody, you know, and everybody used the words bold and experimental, and every pilot was described as bold and experimental, and you know, in the 70s. And so, because it was live, nobody really saw it till it came on, and then it was on. And then once it was on, there was the first weekend of You Can't Do That on Television, and then, you know, Western civilization, as we know it, didn't
crumble.
It didn't crumble, no. And the reviews were mixed, and the numbers were okay, and then there was a second show, and then we were suddenly on, and then we were, and then we gained momentum.
And then it became appointment television.
Yeah, it was a.
Don't want to be home by 11:30.
Yeah, for a certain generation. I think there was another generation that had absolutely no interest in it, and remains to this day with almost no interest in it.
They don't care.
It was a great. It's like, you know, catching a touchdown pass or something like that. You had a great moment. You know, you made people laugh at that time, and you know, you're not going to. You know, you got a different game playing, but it's fun to watch. You know,
you had a moment, and you happened to be there where it was happening, and
it was
you enjoyed the ride, and said
it was a great job, and it was fun, and people like it. People loved it. And it's fun, you know. I like the show that's on now. The current cast, I think, is very good. I'm actually going to do it in a couple weeks. But it's fun for, you know, you still get a kick out of people saying, it's never going to be as good as it was. That was great. They're okay now, but it'll never be as good as
when
it
you
was.
Were there.
Ah, now that was
that
quality.
Was good. It's this piece of television history going on and on and on. And it's amazing, too, to be a part of a show that everyone feels like they own a part of, you know.
Yeah.
People will walk up to you and, you know, the comments range from it's not as funny as it used to be to, yeah, you guys, you know who's good? Belushi.
Yeah.
You know, okay.
Yes,
right?
Of
duly
course.
Noted. Yes.
You were on Saturday Night Live this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Why do you, this is what, you now, you have done it, what, six or seven times?
Six, yeah.
Six times. You love doing it?
I do. It takes me back to my show days. There's something about that.
When you were doing television in New York.
Or theater, musical,
right.
Comedy. It is essentially a Broadway review show of a very old-fashioned kind,
yeah.
With the skits and songs and dancing and girls, and it's a very old-fashioned kind of American theater, which happens once a week. They do a Broadway show once a week. It's live. It's an amazing thing how it gets done. It's very hectic right up until the moment you get there. And then they say, you know, Chris Walken, and the door opens and you come out, and it really takes me back. And I love it.
Is it as much fun today as it's ever been for you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah. Come on.
It's you know, yeah, I mean, I certainly enjoy it.
It's always a negotiation with an answer. It's always a negotiation for an answer.
You know, yeah. I'm too old for this stuff. You know.
For what stuff? For having fun?
Right.
What? And for you, sir, it's better.
Huh? Love it. You know, I think I appreciate it more. I think it was always exciting. That time, you know, the last 3-4 hours of it are...
when it comes together.
Well, or it doesn't come together. You don't go out, when you go upstairs after dress rehearsal, you're not walking up going, well, this one's going to come together. It's ability to scare me, you know, to my core is why I think I'm still there, because you never quite get it right.
You mean from the beginning of the week to
Saturday night?
Yeah,
the show is kind of, I'm sure you've had people on that have explained it, but the show, you don't have to be an optimist at the beginning of the week and a pessimist by the end. You have to kind of believe that all your stuff's going to get on Monday, and then by Saturday you have to just call your parents
gonna make it,
and
you
tell
say
them
it's
go
not
to
gonna
bed. don't bother staying
don't
up.
Don't stay up.
Yeah.
It's sorry, Mom and Dad. I thought it was good, but they didn't.
Yeah. America voted no.
And what happens in that process, though?
Well,
does Lorne just say, does he tell you, I'm sorry, it's not going to be there?
You know.
Or does he have a messenger that does that? You know?
He just.
And your piece of paper
just gladiator
says,
style.
Sorry.
Gladiator style, and you're just giving the thumbs up or thumbs down.
Oh, is that right?
You're whisked away to the lions.
We've been through so much together.
Yeah,
really
going
have.
On us, being on SNL. You're so bonded with your castmates, but you have a special sort of relationship with the people that you start with. Me and Jason Sudeikis, Andy Samberg, and Bill, we all started together, so you kind of feel like that's your class a little bit, because you have your first experiences together. You go through the third year together, ups and downs, everything.
You watch what happens, what you're going through, measuring it to what happens to them, and you get excited for them, and you know, feel for them. And yeah, I mean, in my house, the only picture, no offense to anybody else at SNL, but the only picture I have framed is our, I think it's your last show. We took a group, the four of us sitting on the stage together.
House, the
The only picture is me, Jason. Yeah, it's me, Jason, Andy, and Kristen kind of sitting there like smiling. And it was you and Andy's last show, kind of in a way of being like, we did it. We kind of lasted. You know, how cool is this?